Thank you, our eminent committee chairman, my distinguished colleagues, and to our resource persons for today's hearing. I am author of House Bill 5705 for the renewal of ABS-CBN for 25 years. I am also the author of House Bill 6694, granting a 25-year franchise for ABS-CBN. There may be two bills pending in this committee, but the objective is one and the same: to allow the ABS-CBN to continue operations for the next 25 years. Mr. Chairman, there are allegations of alleged constitutional and legal violations against my bill, against the extension of the ABS-CBN franchise. First is the allegation that Mr. Gabby Lopez is an American citizen and unable to own shares and to be president or the management of the ABS-CBN. The other one is the allegation on the alleged violation of the issuance of PDRs, Philippine Depository Receipts. Mr. Chairman and my distinguished colleagues, as lawyer, as former Dean of the College of Law of San Sebastian College, and of Chairman of the Committee on Constitutional Amendments, let me put my position clear that these allegations have no basis in law and that we should grant the grant of 25 years to ABS-CBN. First, Mr. Eugenio Gabby Lopez III is a Filipino citizen. He was born to Filipino parents under the 1935 Constitution and was in effect when he was born. Automatically, he is a Filipino citizen. That is by virtue of the principle of jus sanguinis, the law of ancestry or by blood. He was born in the U.S. in 1952, and under the U.S. Constitution, he is also a U.S. citizen. That is under the principle of jus soli, or the law of the soil. Mr. Lopez asked the Bureau of Immigration to recognize his citizenship, and it was for this purpose of getting official recognition of this Filipino citizenship in order to get a passport. But a passport is not the sole proof of ownership. There are many Filipinos who have never had passports, but they are Filipino citizens from the very, very beginning. The Department of Justice and the Bureau of Immigration have both recognized recognition of the Philippine citizenship from birth of Mr. Lopez as contained in identification certificate number 00969, dated October 1, 2002. Therefore, being a Filipino citizen, Mr. Lopez may own part of or participate in the management of the mass media company. The second issue is the Philippine Depository Receipts. The PDRs do not give the holders the right to vote nor participate in the management of ABS-CBN Corporation. It does not give the holders ownership over the shares of ABS-CBN Corporation. Since there is no ownership and management of ABS Corporation by PDR holders, there is no violation of the Constitution. The PDR is a conditional option to purchase a share. If the PDR holder is a Filipino, he can purchase and own the shares should he choose to exercise the option. If he's not Filipino, he's not qualified to purchase and own the ABS-CBN shares. The PDRs will be sold in the market and he will only receive the net proceeds thereof. Therefore, sometime in October 1999 and 2014, the ABS-CBN registered and these PDRs were approved by the Securities Exchange Commission in their issuance in both 1999 and 2014 before they were sold to the public. And after reviewing the provisions of the PDRs and ultimately finding that these provisions were compliant with the Philippine Constitution and Philippine laws, the SEC issued certificates of permit to offer securities for sale to ABS-CBN Holdings dated October 4, 1999, and also in 2014. Therefore, Mr. Chairman, there is no truth to the allegation that there is violation of ABS-CBN in the issuance of the PDRs. clearly by the PDR receipt and the contract itself, clearly upon the approval of the SEC, this has been found to be valid. And because of that, Mr. Chairman, first, because it is proven that Mr. Gabby Lopez III is a Filipino citizen from birth, who does not have to do anything to acquire citizenship. He never renounced it or lost it. He can therefore own shares of ABS-CBN and also be president of ABS-CBN. And therefore, that allegation has no basis in the Constitution and in law. Secondly, the PDRs are clearly constitutional and legal, and there's no violation at all in the issuance of ABS-CBN of the PDRs. With that, Mr. Chairman, I call on our distinguished colleagues, after due hearing and notice, to grant a 25-year franchise to ABS-CBN so that they will continue their operations for the next 25 years. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, my distinguished colleagues.